मॉर्निंग ऑल स्टूडेंट्स टीचर्स एंड व्यूअर्स, दिस इज मोहम्मद रियासुद्दीन, प्रिंसिपल तेलंगाना मॉडल स्कूल जरासंगम संगारेड्डी डिस्ट्रिक्ट. नाउ वी हैव द विनर सेशन ऑन कॉमर्स एंड अकाउंट्स फॉर सी सेक्शंस. द टॉपिक इज अकाउंट्स ऑफ नॉन प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस. स्टूडेंट्स, ब्रॉडली वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस. वन इज प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस. The organizations which aim is to earn profits, like all business organizations, like companies or partnership organizations, business firms, corporate sector, shops, shopping malls, etc. Another few organizations have that is the motive is not to earn profit. They are called as service organizations. These are examples such as like charitable trusts, clubs, societies, hospitals, schools. So there is a need to maintenance of accounts for profit organizations as well as non-profit organizations. Our today's topic is accounts of non-profit organizations. Means how we should maintain the topic. Listen the session carefully and note on all the important points, which help you to understand the coming sessions. If you miss the introduction session, you are unable to follow the next session. Normally, this is the first from this session. Take care and follow the important points. And for some, this is a compulsory 10 question. Present the accounts of non-profit organization. Over to Ramarao sir.
Good morning, everyone. Hello. Good morning, everyone. Today we'll be having a session in accountancy, not for profit organizations. Topic is not for profit organization. You are all aware about me, right? You all know me. We had a few sessions earlier. Okay, so this session would be regarding not for profit organizations, and I want everyone to get ready for this session. Okay, so how you have to be ready, like you bring a notebook, pen, and you have to follow very carefully what I'm saying. So we may be having 4 to 5 sessions on this topic, and this is a very important one. Okay, and it carries 10 marks as far as our Telangana Intermediate Board examination is concerned. Okay, so maintain a notebook and a pen. And if you miss a point, you don't have to worry. Just keep watching what the video says. Like you can watch it on YouTube and all. And ensure that you are practicing the problems which I'm saying, which we are solving. Okay? Am I clear? So just get ready for the session. Focus. We'll be making it an interactive session. And I want you all to respond. And I want you all, everyone, to respond by typing the answers in the chat box. Okay, I want everyone to respond. So are you all ready? Okay, so what is that basically we are trying to learn in this topic here? Like, what is a not for profit organization? Okay, what is the meaning of it? What is the difference between capital and revenue expenditure? And what is the difference between capital and revenue receipts? Okay, receipts, I that we said. Okay, receipts, meaning and accounting treatment of important terms. Okay, what are the important terms? And this will be the most crucial part as far as our topic is concerned. So that will be in the second session. Okay, so I want everyone to focus here right from the beginning, like session one, session two and all, so that you will understand what is really going on. Okay, then we'll talk about preparation of receipts and payments account, and then preparation of income and expenditure account, okay, and then preparation of balance sheet with adjustment. These are the objectives which we are going to cover as far as the not for profit organization is concerned, okay. So before I really dwell into what is not for profit organization, I want you all to first answer me this. You have to respond, okay? You have to respond in our chat box. So here is my first question. I'm asking you, what do you call the organization that is involved in trading activity? Trading activity, we all know, right? Buying and selling of goods. So everyone, I want everyone to type the answer. Don't say that you don't know it. We are all well familiar with this concept. Am I clear? Where did we learn about this? Okay, we learned in our first year intermediate, right? So I want everyone to focus on this. Just type the answer. I want you all to type the answer. Actively participate. Okay, so here is the first question. And did you all type that? Okay. So it is the trading organization. We call it as a trading organization. Simple, right? The question itself says what it is all about. Next. Here is the second question. Another simple question I am asking. What do you call the person who is involved in this trading activity? Okay. So if I'm into trading organization, if I'm into trading activity, then what do you call me as? Simple. In our routine life, we come across this, right? So what is that? We call it as, we call him as a trader. Simple. Very simple. Now, further, you have to respond to these questions. I want everyone to respond. These are very important questions to get connected to this topic. And we are all familiar with these questions also. So now here is another question I'm asking. What a trader wants to know at the end of a particular accounting period, okay? Particular period or accounting period. I wanted to make the question more specific. So I'm asking you, what a trader wants to know at the end of a particular period, or what a businessman wants to know at the end of a particular period. Please respond. Okay. You have to get involved into this. Okay. Now, what's the answer? Simple, right? We learned about all these things in our previous, like earlier in intermediate first year. So we prepare. What is that the trader wants to know at the end of a particular period, especially accounting period? We all know what is an accounting period, right? It starts from April 1st and ends in March 31st. So we all know about it. If tax year, accounting year, financial year, everything is one and the same as far as India is concerned. Okay, it's April 1st to March 31st. So what is that your trader wants to know at the end of a particular period? He wants to know whether he has got profit or loss because of his business. Am I clear? Good. Many are responding. I want everyone to respond. And if you miss something also, don't worry. Just keep watching things and YouTube, wherever you come across. Okay? Am I clear? Now, we have already talked about trader that he is preparing, he wants to know profit or loss at the end of the accounting period. Then, in order to know this information, what are the various statements that a trader has to prepare? Okay? Everyone, respond to this question. Answer it. I want everyone to actively participate. It is not just listening, okay? You have to participate in this class. So, what are the statements he has to prepare? It is, if it is a trading activity, we know that the trading account we have to prepare. And most importantly, what are the other statements which you have to prepare? Profit and loss account and what? Balance sheet. Am I clear? So these are the statements. Profit and loss account is an account. Okay. But when we talk about statements, these are the financial statements. So every trader or every business organization has to prepare this. Am I clear? Okay, wonderful. Next, we are not leaving it there. We have to continue. Okay. So I'm asking you further questions. So everyone respond. Even if you're watching this offline, when you play the video of this class, ensure that you are responding in the comments, typing these questions. Don't think that this class is over, so why should I answer and all. You give your thought, your try, okay? Try it, and then definitely you will enjoy learning, okay? Am I clear? So don't think that this is an already displayed video, and don't stop, and don't think that why should I respond to these questions and all. Okay, even if it is not a live class, you have to keep on trying this so that you will catch up with your learning. Okay. Next question, simple question. Again, what is the purpose of a profit and loss account? I said we already discussed that these are the financial statements which the trader prepares. Okay, and we said that we can know what is his profit in an accounting period and all. Now specifically I'm asking, what is the purpose of a profit and loss account? The question itself gives you the answer, and I know that we have come across this. So type it quickly, and it is to ascertain profit or loss. Clear, right? Okay. Next, what is the purpose of a balance sheet? Another question. This question, I know when I asked what is the purpose of a profit and loss account, I know some people may be thinking what's happening and all. Like it will be an easy question. You will say that profit or loss. This is a very simple question. But now I'm asking you another question, which is related to us in, and we have done this in our first year. What is the purpose of a balance sheet? Specific, clear answer I want. Type it in the chat box. Okay, I'm giving you a second. So the purpose of a balance sheet is to ascertain what? Not profit or loss. It is not profit or loss. Then what? Okay. It is to know the financial position of your business. That means you want to know what are the assets and liabilities of your business on a particular date. Am I clear? So what do you understand by the financial position? If you're a businessman, if you're a trader, you want to know what are my assets and what are my liabilities on a particular day. Why I'm stressing on a day, date, and all those things, yes. Like if you talk about profit and loss account, we know we prepare it for a period, like accounting year. But when it comes to balance sheet, it is on a particular day. That means you may be preparing it for March 31st. Okay, or any other day. But if it is profit and loss account, it will be for an accounting period, okay, for a whole year type of thing. Am I clear? Okay, we are good on this. Okay. Another question. Full interactive session will make it, and I want everyone to respond. So we know that a trader wants to know what is your profit or loss at the end of a particular period, right? Now, my question is that, what are the organizations that do not aim for profits but would like to serve the society or its members? Right till now, I was talking about trading organization. I was asking what are the statements prepared, and I know what the trader wants to. Like I asked you earlier also this question, saying that what the trader wants to know after a particular accounting period. So we all answered profit or loss. If a trader wants to know at the end of a particular accounting period, profit or loss, then what do you call the organizations? Okay. Those that do not aim for profit, but they need to do certain activities. That means accepting monies and all. But still, they won't be aiming for profits, and their main motto is to serve the members, that means those who are part of the organization or the society. So what do you call such organizations? They are called as not-for-profit organizations. The name itself tells that they are not aiming for profit. Am I clear? We can also call them as non-trading concerns. Earlier, we used to simply call non-trading concerns, but these days the nomenclature is not-for-profit organizations. We want to be very specific, not-for-profit organizations. Okay, so based on the profit, we have commercial organizations, that means your trading organizations, okay, and not for profit organizations. Now that we are clear, right? Okay, let's step back and see what we are trying to learn. In your first year, we have learned about a sole proprietor, a trader, okay, who prepares financial statements, okay, and those financial statements, what are they? Profit and loss account and balance sheet. Trading account and all, we know that, right? Profit and loss account and balance sheet. Why? To know profit or loss, and then to know the financial position. And we are very clear about that, right? In the first year. Now, we are talking about such an organization which does not aim for profits. So, the classification goes like this. We call the sole proprietor comes under the category of commercial organization and not-for-profit organizations. When we talked about, we'll see what it is. Okay, that is our topic. And it is one of the most easiest concepts which you can learn. Okay, are we ready? Okay, so the primary objective of our not-for-profit organizations, I told you that it is to serve the members of that particular organization or to serve the society. So that is what a not-for-profit organization means. And again, I'm telling that this organization, why we call it as not-for-profit organization, because it does not aim for profits. Clear? Right. What are the examples? Then immediately the next question that comes to my mind is, like, as a student is, okay, does organizations exist that do not aim for profit in this world? Yes. Yes. Many NGO organizations are there. Many other organizations are there. Like what? Educational institutions, charitable institutions, cooperative societies, professional associations, cultural associations, libraries. Okay. So when we talk about educational institution, every educational institution does not aim for profit. You may be saying, sir, these days educational institutions, schools and other educational institutions, they are taking so much amount of fee and all those things. We are not talking about those organizations. We are talking about those organizations whose objective is to provide education, okay, and to serve the society without taking any money, okay. So those institutions, they may be collecting a little amount of fee, okay, but they will not be exploiting the parents and students. They literally try to serve the society. They may be collecting those amounts or fees for their existence or for their survival. Okay, that is the difference which you have to understand. So we'll see some of them. Like, for example, I want tomorrow in the next session 2, I want you all to tell what is IFCO, or in the chat box, you tell me what is an IFCO. Okay, I'll tell about Amul and other things. These are the cooperatives. And you know what Amul makes, right? And you must have consumed that. What is it? That also you type in. So these are all like not-for-profit organizations. And there may be some hospitals. You may be coming and saying, sir, we have hospitals, okay? Those who charge a large, huge amount, but definitely there are very many hospitals which do not charge high fees and all. Okay, even they serve it free. So if you go there, your treatment would be free. And we know there are many charitable institutions like Mother Teresa and all great people, they'll be doing charity. And there are many NGO organizations. Okay, and there may be clubs for recreation. Say, for example, Hyderabad Golf Club is there. Okay, so that also, it comes under not-for-profit. So now the next point is, okay, fine. You said trading organization aims for profit, okay, or loss. And what do they sell? They sell goods or services. Okay, we are very clear about that. Okay, now the next question that comes to my mind as a student is, you are saying like not-for-profit organizations, they do not aim for profits. Okay, then how do they survive? What is the basis for them to survive? Okay, that is the question that eats my mind, right? When I'm listening to this, topic is very simple. Trading organizations, which aim for profit, not-for-profit organizations, which does not aim for profit. Okay, and we talked about all these charitable institutions, hospitals, educational institutions, okay, professional institutions, all this, they do not aim for profit. We know that. We understood that. Then how do they survive? Who is giving them money? How do they get their monies? Okay, so how those organizations survive is they depend upon the donations. This is a familiar word. Okay, we'll be coming more into the details of this, okay, at a later stage. But right now, okay, we'll just go with the basic meanings of this. Many people may be there who may be donating for a hospital, okay? Many people may be there, they may be saying, okay, here is the donation for an orphanage home, right? So that money they will use for their existence or survival. Next, grants. Okay, grants, what they get from a government, from the government, okay, which need not be repaid back. Okay, subscriptions, the amount which is paid by the members of an organization. Say, for example, when I'm talking about Girl Club Association, the members who joined it may be periodically paying for that, for their membership fee. Okay, so such type of thing will be the source for their income and survival of the organization. Okay, clear, right? Step back, think about it. Okay sir, fine. What is that we are trying to learn from not-for-profit organizations? We have to prepare accounts for these. In first year we prepared for trader, sole proprietor, we have learned, right? And we have prepared our final accounts for them. But here we'll be preparing our accounts for not-for-profit organization, not in this session. Okay, in this session, we'll be focusing mainly on the conceptual part. And in the next session, we'll be focusing about how to treat the various items. Okay, am I clear? And then we'll slowly move on. So second session, it will be much more important than the first session. Like that, each session will be very much linked. You have to focus a lot. Just to summarize, not-for-profit organizations, what are the features? Okay, so they are, one thing is they are service oriented. We all know very clearly they are service oriented, okay, because they are not aiming for profit, right? This service is not the other service which you are talking about. We are talking about service which may be little paid, right? Okay. Their aim will not be profit. When I say service, don't get stuck into that word. Simply, they won't aim for any profits. Okay. Now, it promotes art, science, promotes art, science, religion, and spiritualism. You may be thinking, sir, you talked about not-for-profit organizations, and you said that like it serves the society and it serves the members. How this art, science, religion, and spiritualism things are coming into this? So everyone from the society, from different walks of life, okay, there may be artists, there may be people who are interested in science, some people may be interested in promoting religion, okay. So all these people, what they can do, they can float an organization, but that organization may not be really focusing on profit, but to promote that aspect of our society. Like when I say art, there may be art organizations which promotes it, okay? Religion is very common, okay? And in education, when we talk about education also, like education, there will be minority institutions which may not really be focusing on collecting fees and all. They may be focusing on serving its member society, members, like its community, right? So like that, there will be many not-for-profit organizations. And now we know when we are talking about trading organization, the trader we know that he gets profit. He will assess his profit or loss. Based on that profit or loss, he will proceed further to develop the business or take home that profit. That is what he does. Any businessman does that only, right? What is that I'm talking about? When you know that you have got profit, what the trader or businessman does, he takes the profit to home, okay? Spend happily, buy new things and all. Or what he does, he may invest back into business. That means if he has got a small business, he may try to invest it into business and expand it. Okay, that is what he does with that profit. Okay, now the question is, what is surplus here and what is that we are trying to do in a not-for-profit organization? If the money is collected by the not-for-profit organization is more than the expenses incurred by that particular organization, then we call it as surplus. Am I clear? Sorry. Am I clear? Okay. So that amount, we call it as surplus. That means for a trader, we call it as a profit. But we will not be using the profit word here. Why? Because this is not a profit organization. Am I clear? Yeah. Next. How do they do service? We already discussed about from the donations, subscriptions which they receive from the members and all. Now, this is a very important question which you have to recollect. Okay, very important one for our understanding. Okay, we should have been remembering this. What is that? Where do trading organizations get their information to prepare financial statements? That is, what are those financial statements? Profit and loss account and balance sheet, right? We know we have trading account. So, where do they get the information from? Simple answer. Type the answer in the chat box very quickly, please. Everyone should actively participate. Okay. Everyone type the answer. First point or first thing that comes to my mind, since I have already done for my sole proprietor as a student, the first thing that comes to my mind is a trial balance, right? Trial balance. Okay. But trial balance, we all know, it is just a statement which is prepared to check the arithmetical accuracy only. So we know trial balance consists of debit balances, credit balances and all. But where do the information come for trial balance? How does it flow into the trial balance? So we know that we prepare ledger accounts. Okay. Based on the ledger accounts, that means we prepare cash, we prepare personal accounts. Okay, we prepare real accounts like machinery account, buildings account and all. I'm showing cash separately, though we know that it is both an account and a ledger. So for that point, I was just trying to bring your attention onto that particular account. Okay. Okay. So all this information from where? From ledger accounts, including cash account. Where is that all this information we are making them flow into? Or we are taking this information and we are putting this information to, we are preparing a trial balance. Okay. And from trial balance, what is that we are trying to prepare? We are trying to prepare a trading account, profit and loss account, and a balance sheet. If it is a manufacturing organization involved in trading activities, then you will have a manufacturing account, you will prepare trading account, you will prepare profit and loss account, and you will prepare a balance sheet. Okay. So information, where am I getting from? Ledger accounts and cash account. Am I clear? Okay. As far as trading organization is concerned, the information, that means your sole proprietor is concerned, the information we get it from ledger accounts. Simple word, ledger accounts. Okay. Which includes cash account also. Am I clear? So based on that, what you are preparing? You are preparing your trading account. You are preparing your profit and loss account. And you are preparing your balance sheet. We already know what is a profit and loss account. We already know what is a balance sheet. Am I clear? Moving on. Next question that comes to my mind is, like, as a student, you may be thinking or you may be wondering, sir, do we prepare financial statements for not-for-profit organizations? You are saying that not-for-profit organization, that is non-trading concerns, do not aim for profit. We are very clear about that. They do not aim for profit. They serve the society. They serve the members of that organization. Then do they really prepare financial statements? Do we prepare financial statements for not-for-profit organizations? Do we prepare profit and loss account? Do we prepare balance sheet? Okay. Yes, you prepare financial statements, but you will not call it as profit and loss account. Okay. We call it as income and expenditure account. Balance sheet is balance sheet. We call it as it is. Okay. Then the next point that comes to my mind as a student, or you may be wondering, like income and expenditure. If you remember our profit and loss account in the first year, okay? So on the debit side, what were you showing? Expenses. On the credit side, what were you showing? Income. Simple. Here also is the same thing you'll be doing, okay? But the terminology or the caption for that account is not the profit and loss account. It is income and expenditure account. Okay. And balance sheet is, you will show the financial position. That means what are your assets and what are your liabilities. Am I clear? Next question that comes to mind is, okay, fine. Now I understood, as a student for a not-for-profit organization, I have to prepare an income and expenditure account and I have to prepare balance sheet. Okay. Where do we get this information as far as income and expenditure account is concerned or preparing balance sheet is concerned? Do I have to prepare a trial balance? The simple answer is you will not be preparing any trial balance. Please remember that we are working for not-for-profit organization. And also we know that a trial balance is just a statement to check the arithmetical accuracy of your ledger accounts. Then the next thing that comes to our mind is, like, okay, fine, we don't prepare a trial balance. And then where do we get the information from? We get the information from a cash book. That means receipts and payments account. Do you remember our first year? Like, we prepared different types of cash book, right? So receipts and payments account is one of the method, one of the ways which you prepare your cash book, single column cash book. It's a simple cash book. So from this information, we are going to prepare our financial statements for not-for-profit organization. Am I clear? Okay. Then the next question that comes to mind is, like, okay, fine. You said trading organizations, they look for profit or loss. That is the reason why they are preparing profit and loss account. Here, for not-for-profit organization, instead of income, instead of profit and loss account, we are preparing income and expenditure account. When I'm preparing sole proprietor profit and loss account, I'm knowing, like, I'm trying to find out what is profit or loss. So if I get profit, I'm saying profit. If I get loss, I'm saying loss. What about the not-for-profit organization? What about non-trading concerns? What do you call them? If whatever the income this non-trading concern receives is more than its expenditure, then what do you call it? We call it as surplus and not profit. Remember that. We call it as surplus. And the next question is, like, when we talk about loss, okay, that means your expenditure is more than your income, what do you call it as? That we call it as not loss, we call it as deficit. Am I clear? We call it as deficit. And receipts and payments account, you are very clear, right? Okay. So to summarize, Okay, what are the three things we are preparing for not-for-profit organization? The next question that comes to my mind is, like, as a student is, sir, do I need to prepare a receipts and payments account? Normally, you have to prepare a receipts and payments account also. Sometimes, okay. But as far as our intermediate level is concerned, what they do is they will give you a receipts and payments account, and they will ask you an income and expenditure account and a balance sheet. Okay, balance sheet also very rarely they ask. Mostly they will ask how much mostly they will ask you to prepare income and expenditure account only. Simple. Am I clear? So stepping back, take a second back. Recollect whatever the things we discussed about so far now. Okay. So as a student of accounting, what you need to understand, okay, now we are preparing accounts for non-trading concerns. That means organizations which do not aim for profit. Clear? Okay. So where do I get the information to prepare these accounts? I get information from receipts and payments. Okay. And what do I prepare? Like, I prepare an income and expenditure. For what purpose? To know what is my surplus and to know what is my deficit. Okay, next. And balance sheet, you already know, right? Balance sheet. If you want to know the financial position, that means your assets or liabilities, we need to prepare balance sheet. Whether it is trading organization or any organization, balance sheet will be the same terminology which will be used. Okay, am I clear? Shall I proceed? Everyone, right? And this is the format. I will come back to this, but for your understanding, I'm giving you a format. Okay, and you have to get familiar with this format. Okay, this is the receipts and payments account. I will come to this again at the end of the session. But if you are watching a video or something like that, you pause it here. You write it on a notebook. What is your receipts and payments account for the receipts and payments account? Okay, how it looks like and all. If you have a textbook, good. You can go through the pro forma. This is a pro forma, right? You can go through that. So, income and expenditure account. This is the pro forma. I will come back to this before the end of the session, and we'll continue. We'll be discussing about these things, so don't worry. But I'm showing it for the purpose, like, if you are not having a textbook, if you are watching a video, after the video, like, you pause it here, you note them all on your notebook, so that in next session, you will be able to appreciate what we are talking about. Am I clear? Clear. So I already show you receipts and payments account. Okay. It has got a debit and credit side, receipt side and payment side. Okay. We'll come into the details of it at a later stage. But right now, I'm asking you people, after the end of this session, okay, you please note this in a notebook. If you have a textbook, then look at the proformas. Am I clear? If you're not having a textbook, definitely ensure that you're noting it in a book. And if I'm a student who is very much interested in accounting, whether I have a textbook or not, I will definitely note in a notebook. So you have to do that. This is the balance sheet, proforma. Okay, we'll come back to this. Okay, very nice. So now that what we know, what is the difference between a trading organization and a not-for-profit organization? We are very clear about that. And the name itself tells very clearly what is the difference, right? Not-for-profit organization does not aim for profit. If it aims for profit, it becomes a trading organization. It will not come under the category of not-for-profit organization. Okay, we are very clear about that. Now, before we actually start preparing receipts and payment account, income and expenditure account, and balance sheet, we have to get used to certain terms. Okay, what are those terms? We need to get used to. Okay, we'll see that. Expenditure, expenses. You all remember what is the meaning of an expense? Okay, it is the money spent. Okay, so what is that you are trying to spend here? What is an expense, to be more clear? The resources which you are sacrificing to get something, we call it as an expense. For example, if I want to make a pen, if I want to write a pen, if I want to buy a pen, what I have to do? I have to get all that material, right? So all that material, what is that? You need to have a refill, you need to have the plastic body and all. If I'm bringing them together, okay, that means if I'm sacrificing all those resources, then only it will become an pen. So I'm incurring all these things. I'm sacrificing all these resources. That is what is called as an expense. Okay, clear, right? Now we are talking about capital expenditure. Capital expenditure. So what is your capital expenditure? All that expenses, whichever business, that means here it is not business, right? Here what it is not-for-profit organization. So in mind, like, I have to remember this difference. Otherwise, I'll get carried away between trading and non-trading organization. Okay. So in not-for-profit organization, we are talking about this. But the concept is same. What is that? When I talk about capital expenditure, I'm talking about all that expense which I incurred for build, for buying the buildings, machinery, furniture, etc. to maintain in my not-for-profit organization. Okay. And what is the main point which you have to remember as far as capital expenditure is concerned? It is the benefit of it. That means when I'm buying buildings every year or every day, I won't be buying buildings. Okay, right. So once I buy a building, that building is there in my organization. So the benefit of it is spread over a period. Am I clear? The benefit of which is spread over a year. It is not just restricted to that particular period or year. So your capital expenditure benefit will spread across the years. That you have to remember. And where is that you are going to show this capital expenditure? It will be on the asset side of your balance sheet. No doubt in that. It will be on the asset side of your balance sheet. You cannot think, where do I put this? I bought a building. I bought a machinery for my organization. Where should I keep this and all? You should never have any doubt or question in your mind. You have to directly show it in on the asset side of your balance sheet. Am I clear? Sometimes we may get confused with what is the difference between capital expenditure. Okay. Okay. Capital expenditure we know very clear. Now, sometimes we get confused between expenditure and payment. Okay. So expenditure and payment may not be the same. How? We'll see. I spend something. Okay, I bought a pen. I went to a shop. I bought a pen. So that person says 10 rupees. So 10 rupees is my expense. Am I clear? I gave cash. I gave cash. No issues. I made the payment. Okay. So see the difference. See the difference. I bought a pen, 10 rupees. So how much did I expend? How much? What is my expenditure? Like, what is my expense? 10 rupees, right? Did I pay cash? Yes. Am I clear? Clear. Now, I bought a pen. I did not pay the money. That means I have already incurred the expense, but the thing is I didn't pay for the expense. So you have to understand that difference between expense and payment. You will pay because you have expensed. Okay? But this point, you have to be very clear. Next, we all know about the capital expenditure. We have got machines, buildings, major repairs. Okay. Major repairs also come under the category of capital expenditure. This is the only major point which we need to focus on. Next, revenue expenditure. When I talk about capital expenditure, I said the benefit of it will be extended over a period of time. But as far as revenue expenditure is concerned, whatever the expenses which you are making, that expense benefit will be within that period of time, within that accounting year. only 1 year. Okay, normally only 1 year. So I paid salaries. Okay, paying 1 month salary or 1 year salary, I can't make him work for the next year also. So when I'm employing him next year, I have to pay him also. So the benefit what we are talking about is when we talk about revenue expenditure, it is about day-to-day expense, okay, which we are incurring. So we have to be very careful about that. So step back and think, what is the difference between a capital and revenue expenditure? Basis of difference I have shown you. When we talk about the benefits, it's more than 1 year, which one? Capital expenditure. And when it comes to the revenue expenditure, it is within 1 year, right? Nature, when we talk about capital expenditure, it is non-recurring. Non-recurring in the sense it won't be repeated. Am I clear? It won't be repeated. You buy building once, you will keep it for a long period of time in your organization. You won't be buying buildings every year because it involves large amount of money, right? And when we talk about revenue expenditure, it will be for a short period of time. Okay, am I clear about that? Okay. And the capital expenditure, directly you will think about showing it on the asset side of your balance sheet only. Okay, but when it comes to the revenue, like expenditure, it will be shown on the debit side of your income and expenditure. The left side will be the expenditure side and the right side will be the, okay, similarly we have got receipts. Okay, when we talk about receipts, okay, the monies which you, amount of cash which you are receiving, okay, we have got capital receipts and revenue receipts. So capital receipts, okay, they are non-recurring in nature. How? And how do you receive these monies? When you sell your building, when you receive a big donation for a building, or you take a loan from a bank, okay? So all these things will be capital receipts, okay? And directly you have to show it on the liability side. We will keep on repeating these things in this session. So you have to follow me continuously all the sessions, okay? Then only you will be able to appreciate or understand. Next, we have got revenue receipts. These you will receive in your business. They are recurring in, not business. You have to remember that point. Okay, what is that? In your organization, not for profit activities. Okay, so this will be regular routine nature. So you'll be receiving interest, you'll be receiving subscriptions. Okay, and every month you may be going and selling your old newspapers. You may be receiving a locker rent or a building rent which you have given. Okay, all those things. I will be repeating these concepts again and again when we are doing problems. And tomorrow's session, we'll be learning about very important terms. Okay, so you have to follow me all the sessions. Tomorrow's session is going to be like next session, whenever the next session is scheduled. Okay, that will be very important for you, because that is where I will tell you what are the concepts that you have to use when you are preparing your income and expenditure account and balance sheet. So never miss that session. Okay, today we learned about what are the different items like capital expenditure, revenue expenditure, and all those things. Okay, so capital receipts and revenue receipts, difference we know. Okay, what is the base of difference when we talk about source? How do I get capital receipts when you are selling building and all? Revenue receipts in normal course of business. Okay, and capital receipts, they are non-recurring. You won't be selling your buildings every time, right? When I talk about revenue receipts, you will be getting all those subscriptions and all those things. And very clearly I told you, capital receipts, you'll be showing it on the liability side. I'm clear, okay? And the other way is, you may be deducting it from the concerned asset. That means if I sold up buildings, 20 lakhs buildings is there, 20 lakhs worth of building is there. So, what 20 lakh worth rupees building is there? Am I clear? Out of which I sold 10 lakhs worth of building, part of building I sold. That means remaining building is how much? 10 lakhs. So, how am I showing this in balance sheet? I'll be reducing it from the concerned building. So 20 lakhs minus 10 lakhs, which I sold, 10 lakhs I'll show. That way I can show, or directly on the liability side. Okay, am I clear? Okay. Next, we know regular receipts will be showing, we have to credit it, right? Income and expenditure account, left side, debit side, expenditure, right side, credit side, it's income. So we will be crediting it to income and expenditure. Okay, the third item, deferred revenue expenditure. That means you are postponing your expenditure. For example, if I purchase, if I'm spending on my advertisement, I started a new business. So I spend, let's say 10 lakhs or something on advertisement. Advertisement is very costly, you know. I will come about this again and again. So this expenditure, huge amount, if you are showing it on, in the very first year of your business or in the accounting period of your business, then what happens? You will incur losses. That means for profit or not for profit organization, you will run into deficit. So for that reason, what they will do, they will spread that revenue expense, that advertisement expense to various years, like to the subsequent years. So 10 lakhs, 2 lakhs first year, 2 lakhs second year, like that, based on the management decision, they will spread it. Am I clear? So what we have learned so far, for a not-for-profit organization, we know what is the meaning of it. That means it does not aim for profits. It aims to serve the members and society. And we have seen this features of what is our not-for-profit organization. And we have seen what are the financial statements that we have to prepare for. Okay. Your receipts and payments account. Normally in our intermediate, what they do, like examination, what he does is he gives that receipts and payments account, and we have to prepare income and expenditure account and balance sheet, which we will be learning in subsequent classes. Next, we have seen the difference between the capital expenditure and revenue expenditure. Okay. And we have seen the difference between capital receipts and revenue receipts. Okay. Receipts. Okay. Okay. Deferred revenue expenditure. Since I can't show the whole amount of expenditure, especially like advertisement in 1 year, what I am doing it, I'm postponing it. Deferring means postponing it to subsequent years, the other years, so that my deficit will not be more. Okay. So do you have any questions? And remember, like the three financial statements which I have shown, income and expenditure account, receipts and payment account, and balance sheet, that you pause the video, note down those points as I told you. Okay. And if you have any questions, we can deal with them in the next sessions. Next session, please do not miss it. Very important, because we will be discussing about various terms that we have to handle in our income and expenditure account and balance sheet for a not-for-profit organization. So if you have any questions, let me know. And stay home, stay safe, continue learning. And I thank all the respected principal ma'am, sirs, who has given me the opportunity, and especially Riyazuddin sir, who has been coordinating about this session. I thank you all.
Okay. Thank you, Ramarao sir. And thanks to all the students. But I observed the live chat, in that the first half of the live chat, students have responded very well. But in the second half, the students not responded properly. So I request all the students in the coming tomorrow's session, respond positively, and your live chat is viewed, and we are ready to give your answers in this session only. Tomorrow, if you have any doubts, any questions, I request the students to respond and ask the questions through live chat. In today's first half, I have seen the 2-3 questions, like what trading organization called. Many of the students have given the answer as business organization, and some have given the answer as like market. Market is wrong, and business organization is right answer. And what is a person called? Everybody has given the answer as trader, but one or two students has given the answer as consumer. So consumer is not the right answer. Trader is the right answer. So like that way, we are reviewing your live chat. We request all the students to avoid the unnecessary chats and ask the questions about the session. And tomorrow, be attentive, and at the same time, attend the session. Once again, thank you all the viewers and the coordinators and Ramarao sir. Thank you all.